morning to all of our friends and family and visitors. We have a packed house today. We have a very, very, very exciting celebration today for Black History Month. We waited until the end of the month, to the 28th, because they say they save the best for last, and we did. We could have done this a week ago. We could have done it 2 weeks ago. Miss Woodward was saying, come on, let's do it, let's do it. And we realized, let's save it for the 28th. Are you ready?
Yeah!
Okay. There are a whole bunch of different things that we're doing today. We are going to be hearing some things, seeing some things. We have a video screen up here that I know some of us might not be able to see because of the columns. We tried to get the columns taken down, and we were told if we did, the whole top floor might fall. So we left them up, and we're going to do the best we can. So if you cannot see, most of the performances and presentations you will hear as well. So that's why we need to open our eyes and our ears today for today's celebration. If you have a program in front of you, you will see that it is packed from top to bottom, and there are unfortunately even some things not on the agenda, not on the program, that you will be hearing as well. We've spoken to some people. We're going to ask them to come up and talk a little bit about some of the artwork that you see around the perimeter of the gym. And it's going to be really, really exciting to hear about some of the things that are going on in Highview School. This day could not have taken place, this activity, this event could not have taken place if it wasn't for the coordinator of our Black History Month, which entailed more than just the assembly itself, but we had morning announcements every single day talking about wonderful accomplishments and endeavors by our famous African Americans. And I would like for all of us at this point to give a hefty Highview round of applause to our third grade teacher, Ms. Woodward. Thank you, Ms. Woodward. You did an amazing job, so thank you. We are kicking everything off today with an African drum presentation by Roots and Rhythm Drummers. Mr. Bridger shared with me that he knows the gentleman here, so I'm going to ask that after they're done and after you hear just how amazing this is, that Mr. Bridger is going to introduce them for us. So let's hear it for the African drum presentation, the Roots and Rhythm Drummers. Thank you.
morning, good morning. That'll wake you up. Clap it up for Roots and Rhythm. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Just want to give it up. Introduce the drummers. We got two former students here, two former Highview students. Give it up for my man Derek in the hat. Give it up. It's my man Derek. Trevor. Give it up for Trevor. And if this guy looks familiar, this is my big brother right here, Taj. This is my big brother, Taj. Thank you.
Great job, guys. And Mr. Bridgers, too. He was over here. All right. We're going to bring it down just a notch as Mr. Roberts makes his way to the piano. We're going to have Ms. Woodward's class. They're so excited. They're going to perform Lift Every Heart and Sing. Lift Every Voice and Sing, I'm sorry. Mr. Roberts. Sure.
Thank you, Mr. Mastrangelo. When Ms. Woodward asked me if I could contribute to this occasion, and it's my joy to, I thought, but it didn't take me too long to figure out what I wanted to do. We don't have a picture of it now, but there is a sculpture that Mrs. Weiss gave me a picture. It's called Lift Every Voice and Sing, and it's by Augusta Savage. Augusta Savage, I'll read her bio, and then we'll talk about what you're going to hear and see. Born in 1892 and died in 1962. Born to an impoverished minister in Florida, Savage was the seventh of 14 children. Despite strong opposition from her father, she began modeling clay figures at the age of six. Later, as a senior in high school, she was paid to teach other students clay modeling. She moved to New York, graduated from Cooper Union School of Art, and became a portrait sculptor. Through a scholarship, she studied art in Europe and returned to the United States in 1932. She opened her own studio and became the first black artist elected to the National Association of Women Painters and Sculptors. And there's more to this. Just to say that in 1932, for the World's Fair, Ms. Savage created something called Lift Every Voice and Sing, and it was based on the song Lift Every Voice and Sing. That inspired her to create this beautiful figure. And we still don't have it up, but just to describe it, it's in the shape of a harp with the hand of God holding the harp, and there are figures going up this way. Okay. So, and she called it the harp. It was for the 1932 World's Fair. Unfortunately, it was destroyed, so we only have clay models of this. But looking at this and looking at the movement of that, I thought that perhaps Ms. Woodward's class can now reinterpret that work. So what you're going to see is a reinterpretation of Lift Every Voice and Sing by Ms. Savage, and each class is going to interpret it, each group is going to interpret it differently. Sometimes you'll see the children playing the harp, and other times you'll just see the sculpture itself. So we are about to see Lift Every Voice and Sing, and then we will follow that by everybody singing Lift Every Voice and Sing.
Like the day that never the fit. Like on seashores there are shells, like the time that always tells. It holds the key to every heart throughout the universe. It fills you up without a bite and quenches every
every voice I see. Sing. Sing with the heart.
next performance, is a poem, America's Greatest Farmer. And that will be presented by Highview School second graders. So we can turn our attention to stage left and listen to our second graders. Second grade classes. Thank you very much. We have a spoken word presentation by seventh grade student from Woodlands High School, former Highview School student, Mr. Justin Sanchez. Come on up, Justin.
See, we can't change the world unless we change ourselves. Everyone is equal, even ones without wealth. I see you when I see myself. Same ones happy, just trying to seek for help. Love yourself. The human race is constantly moving, and there's some name calling that's constantly using. I won't do it. I stand by the movement. Keep moving. Black history, take you back history. Malcolm X standing up for all black misery. Take back victories. Bring everyone together like Dr. Martin Luther King did for me. Black history, strong black memories. Rosa Parks, Dr. Carter G. Woodson. Took years to get them history books in. Took a while to see how history looks with us. We can't change the world unless we change ourselves. I thank my ancestors for all the love that they've given me. Because now to this day, the spirit to stand up and unite still lives in me. Black history.
Justin Sanchez, well done. Great job, Justin. He recited all of that from memory without glasses and a program in front of him, so I'm very proud. Excellent job. Our next performance is a dance presentation by Summer Irving Carroll, Tatiana Washington, and Aiden White Marquez.
Thank you.
Excellent job. So every year our African American Assembly has a different theme. You kids might have been in ECP, maybe even prior to that. And Highview School, one of our assemblies, was a Jeopardy theme where we had a lot of questions and it was students against students. It was second grade against third grade. Another year we had staff members dressing as famous African Americans and it was more of a who am I, and they would come up and read something and the students had to guess. Today's theme is all about STEAM: science, technology, engineering, arts, and math. And what amazing endeavors and inventions and creations and projects have been brought to the forefront in American history from African Americans. If any of you saw the Oscars, not the debacle at the end, but in the middle when they were talking about Hidden Figures, they had one of the mathematicians that you're going to hear a little bit about later on. So we are certainly going to hear some really wonderful things that's going to accompany the slideshow that we have. So we have third grade participants who will be presenting to you African American STEAM pioneers. Boys and girls.
For finding a way to cure Blue Baby Syndrome. I was born on August 29th, 1910, in Nashville, Tennessee. The character trait that describes me is caring, because I really cared a lot about babies and hoped that they did not get sick or pass away. I have made an impact in today's society because I saved people's lives from passing away. An interesting fact about me is that I was born into slavery. I died on November 26, 1985 because of pancreatic cancer. Who am I?
Good morning and welcome. I am a famous technologist who founded a website that gave girls of color, like me, a chance to code. My website is called Black Girls Code. It is not only for people of color, but it's for all people who would like to learn to code. I was born on January 14, 1967, in Memphis, Tennessee. I went to school and studied electrical engineering at Vanderbilt University. Something interesting about me is that I was listed as one of the 25 most influential African Americans in technology. If I had two words to describe myself, I would say that I am bold and brave because I gave a lot of girls a chance to code in areas where that is not common. Who am I?
I am a famous engineer. I was born on November 22, 1942. In Philadelphia, PA. The character trait that describes me is a risk taker because I travel to outer space to learn new things. I strongly believe in traveling to space and helping the NASA program. I have made an impact on today's society because I became the first African American to travel into space. An interesting fact about me is that I have a degree in aerospace engineering. I am still alive. Who am I? I am Guyan Bluford.
I am a famous artist. I was born in 1917. I am from Atlantic City, New Jersey. I am known for my African American art. A fact about me is that as a kid, I used cardboard as a canvas board. The character trait that describes me is smart and artistic because I love to teach my kids, but once I get home, I paint. Something interesting about me is I love to tell art stories. I died on June 9, 2000. Who am I? Jacob Lawrence.
Thank you.
Catherine Johnson was born in West Virginia on August 26, 1918.
She is 98 years old.
Catherine loved math from the time she was a little girl. She was an excellent student, but as an African American, she was only able to attend school until eighth grade. Then her mom and dad had to drive her over 100 miles to go to high school in another town.
Catherine was a brilliant student.
She attended West Virginia State College and graduated with highest honors at the age of 18, which is when most people start college. She started graduate school the following year and was one of three students to desegregate the university.
Her first job was a teacher.
Later, she worked for NASA as a human computer, performing really hard math calculations. Her math work was fast and accurate. She was such a fantastic mathematician, she helped figure out how to get the first American astronaut up into space and return to Earth. In 1969, Catherine's math skills assisted in getting the first ever astronaut to the moon and back safely. She used geometry to help her.
Despite her extraordinary math ability, Catherine encountered prejudice with NASA and struggled to be accepted as an African-American woman in a male-dominated profession.
In 2015, President Obama gave her the Medal of Freedom.
A book called Hidden Figures tells the story of Catherine and many other African-American female mathematicians whose skills guided early space missions.
It is now a feature movie.
Thank you for Mrs. Woodward's class. And Ms. Wasserman's class. And students from Kendall from Mrs. Dariano, Kira from Senora Sands, happy birthday Kira, Vanessa from Mr. Chavillo's class, and Sarai from Ms. DeLillo's class. Thank you all, great job. So we talked about some things that were not on the program. Our art teacher, Ms. Weiss, worked with students, and I just want her to talk a little bit about some of the projects and some of the recognition that we received. They are here in the gym, and I want Mrs. Weiss to talk a little bit about them. Ms. Weiss.
Thank you. This year, I worked with the second grade team of teachers and all of the second grade classes to bring Dr. Martin Luther King's teachings alive in the art room. And I asked each student, what do all of these things mean to them? And each class drew pictures about what peace meant to them, and fairness, communication, change, hope, and acceptance. And after we finished all of our art, we put it all together, and I sent it up to Albany. And it's been on display in the plaza up in Albany for the entire month. Thank you. Thank you. And just a few days ago, we received a certificate and a thank you letter from Governor Andrew Cuomo. And Mr. M has the original certificate upstairs, but I did make a copy and I put it on the back wall over there where all of the copies of the artwork are. So if you get a chance, please enjoy it. And I'd like to congratulate all the second graders and teachers for working with me on this project.
Thank you, Mrs. Weiss. And boys and girls. So a lot of times when we are 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 years old and we say, I want to be whatever it is you want to be when you grow up. And I don't think Barack Obama, when he was 8 or 9 or 10, if he said, I want to be president of the United States, I don't know that people laughed at him and said, ha, you're never going to be president. Because just a few short years later, he did. He became the President of the United States. So many of you have aspirations or dreams or goals of what you would like to do when you grow up. And it may not necessarily be the President of the United States, but it may be somebody who remains in Greenburgh for their entire lives and does something incredibly special. Our next presentation is actually a video of someone who did just that. Mr. Walter Simon is a community member who has lived in Greenburgh his entire life. He is a chemist, he is a community member, and he was here not too long ago in February and performed a science experiment for Mrs. Woodward's class, and we are about to see Mr. Walter Simon in action.
I want everyone to put on their safety goggles. My goggles are small. You got big goggles. Do you have any more of these big goggles? Okay, I got them. And I'm going to put on an apron so I don't splash anything on my clothes. And now we're going to talk about chemicals. We're going to find out what products are chemicals. Again, what is this?
Tin foil.
Aluminum foil.
Yeah. And what is the chemical this is made out of?
Tin.
Tin or aluminum.
Or metal.
But what's the name of the
aluminum.
Metal?
Aluminum.
That's right. This is aluminum. And aluminum. Aluminum is another chemical. But what I'm going to do on this experiment, I'm going to take aluminum. Now, would you say aluminum is a safe chemical?
Yes.
Well, no, you can't eat it.
Oh, you can't eat it. But what do you do with aluminum? Give me some examples of what you do with aluminum.
Yeah. Let's say I'm going to like wrap up pizza for lunch for school.
Right. You wrap up your lunch. So I'm gonna put some aluminum here that we use every day. We don't eat it, but we use it and we put it on our food, and it does not contaminate our food. But in fact, it helps keep our food nice and clean and safe, okay? Then to that, I'm gonna add some
H2O.
Okay, add some H2O. Okay, what happens when I add water to H2O? H2O to aluminum. What happens? Nothing happens, okay? But now what I'm going to do, I'm going to take a chemical called sodium hydroxide. And I'm going to read, it says, first aid, do not swallow, do not get in your eyes, do not get on your fingers. This will cause serious burns. This is a danger. However, if this is used properly, you know when your sink are clogged up and they pour something in your sink to unclog the sink?
Mm-hmm.
You know what's in that?
Mm-hmm.
Sodium hydroxide. So it's used, if it's used improperly, it can burn your hand.
Thank you.
Okay, you can turn it off now because we ended the experiment and we all saw it. Thank you very much for being my timekeeper. How about a clap for, what's your name?
Maya.
Maya, you have a daughter named Maya. Okay? So, a granddaughter rather named Maya. Okay? So thank you very much. So I'm saying if it's used properly, it's very helpful. You can clean out your dentures, but if it's used improperly, it can burn you. So what I'm going to do, I'm being very careful to use it properly. And that's why I have my goggles on, that's why you have your goggles on. And I'm going to add some to this. And then I'm going to put a balloon over.
Oh, it's going to.
And then I'm going to turn this around. Oh boy, it's getting hot. Getting hot.
How?
I don't know. I see stuff in the bubble.
Oh, my God.
That's so cool.
That is amazing. That is the coolest thing I've ever seen.
It's stuck in the bubble.
It's bubbling.
Oh, my God.
That's
the peach.
Yes, it's
like
bigger.
Okay.
No, that can't be.
Boy, no more aluminum foil in here.
What?
All reacted. Okay. It's all reacted.
Oh my God.
Oh, you can blow a balloon?
No.
Boys and girls.
Yeah, we had a reaction. The aluminum foil is gone.
And you have a bullet.
The aluminum foil is gone.
And you have a bullet.
And we have a balloon. And the balloon is filled with
hot air.
It's full with
hot air.
Carbon dioxide.
Well, it's full with a gas. We don't know what the gas is. It's full with a gas. So with this reaction,
now it turned black.
There's nothing left.
It turned black.
Okay. So the question is,
how did it turn black?
What is in this container? The balloon. There is. Now, if I turn this on and put it in the air, what happens? Do you see anything that happens?
No. It just flickers.
It
keeps turning off.
Yeah, well, it's turning off because my hands and my fingers. But now I'm holding it. Does anything happen when you just put that in?
Yeah, it's floating.
Yeah, just a regular flank, okay? Hydrogen.
Yeah.
Hydrogen. Guess what? Hydrogen. And guess what? Guess what? We talked about different chemicals and what is in water?
H2O.
What is the H in water?
Hydrogen atoms.
Hydrogen atoms. You see? So the same hydrogen that's in water that I can drink is the hydrogen atom that just exploded.
Oh, yeah.
But it's in different form. This, this is connected with oxygen to make water. And the hydrogen that exploded is just hydrogen by itself. You see? And so they're all chemicals, but depend upon how they combine with other chemicals will determine whether it's safe, whether it's dangerous, whether it will explode, or whether or not it will not explode. But they're all chemicals, depending upon how they are connected with other chemicals. Okay?
So Mrs. Woodward's class got to see that firsthand, and we wanted to make sure that you all got a chance to see. So Mr. Simon had a prior engagement and couldn't make it this afternoon or this morning, but if we clap loud enough, he'll probably hear us. So how about if we give a big round of applause for Mr. Simon? Our last presentation is another spoken word by another former Highview student. She's now in 10th grade. Let's hear it for Ms. Kayla Addison.
DLDG. Dear little dark girl, you are the most prettiest little dark girl I've ever known. Little dark girl, you may be dark, and yes, it will be hard. But I'm here to tell you, little dark girl, that you will be great, and you will not be defined by the pigment of your skin. Little dark girl, your lovely dark chocolate skin will shine like the moon at night, lighting the way for all the other pretty little dark girls. Little dark girl, don't ever, ever put your head down at the ground where your ancestors used to pick cotton from. Rise like the sun. Also, remember to love yourself, love your skin, and be proud to show it off to all the haters that would love to have your skin. Always and forever, pretty black and blacky. Thank you.
Kayla Addison, everyone. Wonderful job, Kayla. Boys and girls, how about one more round of applause for all of our presenters and performers today? Everyone did an amazing job, as always. We'd like to thank Mr. Parker for recording this for us, and he will. Thank you, Mr. Parker. He will complete his editing genius, and it should be ready for us in about 20 minutes. Or maybe a couple of weeks. But either way, it'll be up and ready to go on local cable access for us. So thank you, Mr. Parker. We have just one more before we head out for the day. Just one more person who would like to say a couple of words. I believe it is Ms. Mangum, who is... I don't know how that happened. I looked over to the right. She was there. I just heard her behind me. But let's hear from Ms. Mangum.
Good morning. Mrs. Woodward, can you please come up here, please? On behalf of all of the parents of Highview, we would like to thank you for spearheading the Black History Committee, for organizing this assembly, and for focusing and recognizing African Americans in STEAM. Thank you. We appreciate you, and we recognize all of your hard work. Thank you.
Right. Boys and girls, you again were amazing. The drummers, I'm going to ask that you play us out, because our teachers are going to escort the students out, some to the right, some to the left, And with that, boys and girls, have a wonderful rest of the day. For all of our visitors, thank you for coming and taking part in our Black History Assembly. Mrs. Woodward and committee, thank you very much. Guys, let's hit it.